Everybody was running around, hysterical.
Police say a man stole a car with a baby inside, then led them on a chase. How it all ended, two counties away.
A dog found abandoned and starving outside a Jessamine County apartment building. Now investigators are trying to track down the owner.
New video from a drone tonight shows just how much damage a roof collapse caused at a Lexington church.
Tracking, alerting, protecting. WKYT News starts now with breaking news.
And good evening. Tonight we are tracking the investigation into a deadly crash on a Lincoln County road. Accident reconstruction units have been called to that scene.
That crash happened around 9 tonight on U.S. 127 near Jeffries Lane, just north of Houstonville. This is video just in our newsroom. State police say one person was killed in the crash. Three vehicles were involved. They're trying to figure out how the crash happened. We want you to keep checking WKYT.com for the very latest updates. What was supposed to be a quick fill-up at a gas station turned into a frightening ordeal for a family. Police say a man stole their car with an 8-month-old baby in the back seats.
Police began searching for the car moments after the theft at a gas station in Georgetown. They soon spotted it on Interstate 75 in Madison County and chased it until the car crashed on 4 Mile Road near Richmond. And that's where the baby was found safe, nearly 50 miles from the gas station. Garrett Weimer is tracking the investigation tonight. It's our top story at 11.
It all started here at the Pilot truck stop on Cherry Blossom Way in Scott County. That's where investigators say a man stole a Hyundai Santa Fe with an 8-month-old girl inside.
I heard him say there's a baby inside, and the guy sped out. Everybody was running around, hysterical.
Police say the man led them on a chase that brought them onto 4 Mile Road, where they say the driver crashed into a tree and took off into the woods. Police tracked him down, but they say the man shot and killed himself while police tried to negotiate with him. Inside the car, the baby was okay, still latched in her car seat, which police say had turned upside down. I was driving on 4 Mile Road when the mother was reunited with her baby, the mother running out of a sheriff's car and hurrying inside an ambulance that stopped to meet them. Police say the baby was taken to the hospital to be checked out. From beginning to end, police say it was a situation that took a toll on everyone.
And just the thought of having, you know, putting yourself in that own situation and just trying to imagine what that would actually be like. It's gut-wrenching just thinking about it.
Investigators say it's not a happy ending because the man did die, but they're thankful the baby and everyone else is okay. In Richmond, Garrett Weimer, WKYT.
Now, police have not released the name of that suspect. Witnesses told us someone in the family was pumping gas and briefly just turned away when the suspect jumped in the car and stole it.
New tonight, we now know the names of two men killed in a crash in Lexington this afternoon. The Fayette County coroner has identified them as 64-year-old Douglas McNally of Middletown and 63-year-old John Akey of Lexington. Investigators say McNally was driving a BMW. Akey was his passenger. Lexington police say that car and two other vehicles were involved in the crash on Bryan Station Road near Johnston Road. The BMW ended up pinned against a fence. Police are trying to figure out what caused the crash.
Tonight, some slow-moving and photogenic storms have been dumping heavy rain across parts of Kentucky. Many of you have been sharing eyewitness pictures of clouds like this one. This one's out of Lancaster. And after the storms moved through, they left behind a vivid sunset. Here's what it looked like in Lexington tonight. How about that? Chief Meteorologist Chris Bailey's been admiring these pictures. He shows us what he's tracking right now. Pretty neat stuff there.
Yeah, amazing stuff. My Twitter feed absolutely going crazy tonight with some of those absolutely astounding pictures throughout central and eastern Kentucky. Things are calming down a little bit out there now. We look at Defender and we are picking up on some leftover showers and rumbles of thunder out there, but that big complex of thunderstorms that was so photogenic has dropped all the way into the Volunteer State of Tennessee, leaving behind still a streak of some very heavy rain showing up Russell Springs, Lake Cumberland, into parts of the Somerset area. That extends a little farther to the north through Lancaster. Some heavy rain right on top of Berea into Richmond, Madison County. What do we call it? Good sleeping weather with some raindrops on the roof tonight. Yep, you've got that going on. Lexington Metro beginning to see the skies clean up just a little bit. Here's that big complex of storms, though. Take you back 4 hours ago. That dropped its way on through the area, had the leading edge of that in what is known as a shelf cloud. So what do our weather watchers do? They go out and they take a shelfie. What is the shelfie? Well, it's a selfie in front of the shelf cloud. Chris Reese, our weather watcher from Lexington, with that. Greg Walters over into Lawrenceburg with that electric lightning picture between two power poles, and then the gorgeous sunset to Lexington and most areas from James Starr. Breathtaking sunset. Guys, when I come back in a little bit, we're going to bring this cold front into town, and I'll show you why that means a gorgeous end to the month of July in just a few minutes.
A disturbing discovery near a dumpster in Nicholasville. Jessamine County Animal Care and Control says someone found a starving dog that had been abandoned.
The dog was in bad shape, but it is now being nursed back to health. But who abandoned it? First, a warning to you. Some may find some of this video hard to watch. New at 11, Monique Blair has the story from the live desk. Monique?
Well, Amber and Sam, Jessamine County Animal Control is actively looking for the owner of that puppy because they say she was so skinny. She was near death when she was picked up this morning outside the Buford Place Apartments in Nicholasville.
She was extremely emaciated, which caused into question of how it got into that condition.
This six-month-old puppy, which Animal Control believes is a pit bull mix, was picked up Wednesday, extremely emaciated and exhausted.
She didn't have a lot of energy initially because obviously she's been without food for quite some time. She actually had trouble walking.
After spending a few hours at a veterinary clinic, the puppy was able to get some energy back through several small feedings.
You can tell she's just grateful that she's getting attention, she's getting food, water. The big thing is the food and the water, but the attention goes a long way with animals.
Now Animal Control is asking for your help finding the owner of this puppy.
That's the only way we're going to find out how the dog got in this condition and who did that.
Jessamine County Director of Public Services Mike Cassidy says it does appear this puppy had an owner because her fur shows she did wear a collar at some point in time.
We definitely see a lot of animal cruelty cases. I think that's pretty much throughout the state of Kentucky, there's a lot of animal cruelty cases. We just work the hardest we can to gather all the evidence and prosecute the person to the fullest.
Now, Animal Control says this puppy does have a very long road to recovery and will not be up for adoption until she is healthy. At the live desk, Monique Blair, WKYT.
Monique, thank you. Jessamine County Animal Care and Control is collecting donations for the puppy's care. We have information for how you can help at WKYT.com.
Tonight, firefighters are trying to figure out what caused a fire at the FedEx warehouse in Lexington. Firefighters say a truck caught fire this afternoon in a dock at the facility on Buck Lane. Dozens of firefighters responded. They say it didn't take long to put the fire out.
The sprinkler system had managed to contain the fire to the truck. We stretched some lines and extinguished the truck.
While the fire itself did not damage the warehouse, firefighters say there was smoke and water inside the building. At last check, FedEx employees had not been allowed back into the building.
New tonight, a federal judge has dismissed part of a 2011 fraud lawsuit against disability attorney Eric Kahn. According to our news partners at the Herald Leader, the judge ruled the whistleblowers who filed it didn't provide evidence that any of Kahn's clients improperly won disability benefits. But the judge ruled the lawsuit can proceed with counts claiming Kahn conspired with a Social Security Administrative Law Judge to collect legal fees he wasn't entitled to.
We have some new video tonight showing the roof of a Lexington church after it collapsed. Unmanned Services Incorporated shared this drone video that the company shot today. Part of the roof at Palomar Baptist Church on Fort Harrods Drive collapsed this morning. No one was injured. The pastor says church leaders first started noticing problems with the roof back in the spring. And for the last few months, they had not been using that part of the building where the roof collapsed.
We believe in prayer, and we know that God is able to get us through a tight place like this. And the building went up by faith, and it'll go up by faith again.
The pastor says his church does have insurance to pay for the damage. No word tonight on what caused it to collapse.
New tonight, a presidential candidate used the internet to rally his supporters across the country. Hundreds of rallies were held at the same time tonight for Democrat Bernie Sanders. One of them was at Al's Bar on North Limestone in Lexington. The Vermont senator addressed each rally simultaneously through the internet.
It's the largest digital meetup politically in history, as far as we know. And so it's really big.
In recent weeks, polls have shown Sanders running second in the race for the Democratic nomination behind former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton.
Tonight, wreckage from what appears to be an airplane has washed ashore on a remote French island in the Indian Ocean.
Investigators want to know if it came from a Malaysia Airlines plane that mysteriously disappeared more than a year ago. Danielle Nottingham has the latest.
Investigators are taking a close look at this 6-foot-long piece of metal found on Reunion Island off the east coast of Africa. Sources tell CBS News Boeing investigators believe the debris appears to be from a 777, the same type of aircraft as Malaysia Airlines Flight 370. So far, they've only looked at pictures of the debris and cannot say with certainty that it came from the missing jetliner. Flight 370 carried 239 passengers and crew on a flight from Kuala Lumpur to Beijing when it disappeared from radar in March 2014. Australia has led an expansive search effort in the southern Indian Ocean using radar and sonar. The debris discovered this week was found thousands of miles away near Madagascar. Malaysia is sending a special team to the island to examine and possibly identify the debris. Despite the ongoing search, not a single piece of the missing plane has ever been located. In January, Malaysian officials said all on board the flight were presumed dead. Danielle Nottingham, CBS News, Los Angeles.
An Australian official says the discovery is unlikely to change the seabed search for Flight 370 in the southern Indian Ocean.
New tonight, investigators say a young man from eastern Kentucky has died while hiking in Colorado. They say the 21-year-old Joseph Combs fell off a cliff. He was originally from Hazard. Friends say he had moved to Colorado to start a new job as a chef. He graduated from Hazard High School 3 years ago, and those who knew him say his true passion was soccer.
As a teammate, he was great. As a student, he was the most laid-back kid on the planet. He was just a good kid. Anything that you need done, all you have to do is ask Joseph, he'd do it. I mean, he had that community spirit. I mean, nothing was too big to ask Joseph to do.
His funeral will be Friday night at 7 at Maggard's Mountain View Chapel in Perry County.
New tonight, Rolling Stone magazine now faces a lawsuit over a story about rape that the magazine later retracted. Court documents show three University of Virginia graduates and members of a fraternity profiled in the story are suing Rolling Stone, its publisher, and the story's author. The three men are seeking damages for defamation and emotional distress. Rolling Stone apologized for inaccuracies found in the story after it was published.
10 days after a traffic stop turned deadly in Cincinnati, a police officer has been charged with murder. A grand jury indicted University of Cincinnati police officer Ray Tensing. He turned himself in today. Investigators say that 43-year-old Samuel DuBose was shot during a traffic stop. The university says the officer has been fired. He'll be arraigned tomorrow. A rally was held tonight honoring DuBose outside a courthouse in Cincinnati.
Investigators have released new details about a massive fire at General Electric's appliance park in Louisville earlier this year. Firefighters say outdated sprinklers and broken hydrants caused major issues as they try to contain the fire in April. Investigators say the fire caused more than $50 million in damage to Building 6 at the park. Firefighters say the damage may not have been as bad if all of the hydrants had worked properly.
The one next to the building where the initial attack was made, the stem was broken and they couldn't uncap it to be able to use it. The domestic hydrant behind the building had been marked out of service and carried out of service tag.
Firefighters said they had warned GE many times over the last decade that sprinklers and hydrants needed to be upgraded. GE officials blame another company for the sprinkler issue. Firefighters think a lightning strike or something electrical caused that fire.